Hey makers, today we're going to be making a light bright, which is an old sort of a toy. Maybe your parents had one, and they're really cool. You've got a grid with these holes in it, and you can take all sorts of little colored pegs and use them to make a design, like this broccoli. Now these are little ones. We're going to make a huge one out of some pegboard and some holiday lights. The first thing you want to do is test to see that your holiday lights work. Hey, so this string works, and we're going to use it to get started. Before we start putting this into our pegboard, though, we need to have a plan. I'm going to use some graph paper, which is a special kind of paper with grids on it. I'm going to mark out the size of our board, which I've measured is about 18 holes by 48 holes. And we're going to pretend that this first hole here is this first spot there and on down the line, and that it goes in both directions. So we've sort of got a little map of what we're going to make. So first I'm going to count off my first spot, and I'm going to go in about 10, so 2, 4, 6, maybe a little further, 12, yeah, that looks good. I'm going to measure 3 down, 4, I'm going to start right about here. Put an X, mark off a couple more, where I'm going to put, I think I'm going to make some sort of a smiley face. It's a good way to start. I'm going to measure off a little bit. That's about right. So here we've got some eyes. And we're going to measure the centerpiece. Let's put the bottom of the smile about here. And it's sort of nicer to measure off of the center, because then we can mirror the sides. The way that we're doing this is kind of like writing on a window. You're going to see it from the other side. And because of that, everything's going to be flipped. So you want to pay attention to that. And if you've got any words, or if you have something that has to be pointing in one direction, you want to sort of do it backwards. So here, we've got our finished pattern. We've got it all marked off. And now, what we can do is we can start laying in our lights. No matter which kind of lights you have, we're going to start with the side that you don't plug into the wall. So we're going to count in to find that starting point that we started with. So it was in, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 squares. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. It was in the fourth square. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You want to take the light, put that in, and we're going to be going over to this side. So I want to move the plug off to the other side. I'm going to take that and a little bit of tape. Down the plug first, and we're going to tape down the light. We're going to be careful not to cover the hole that you're going to be putting another light in, because then you have to jam through it and you might shatter the bulb. It's not fun. So we've got that one. We're going to put one right next to it, right here. Pop that one on. Take another piece of tape. We're going to tape this one down. Just like that. We're going to keep going until we've filled up all of these little squares with X's in them. Beyond that, it's all counting and a little bit of patience. you can see that we've got our little smiley face. It's kind of cool. This is just one thing you could make using a string of lights and some pegboard, but you can make all sorts of things. You can make a sign for your room, put it over your door. You could make a sign for your dog. You could make a happy birthday sign and surprise somebody with it. That'd be really cool. You could communicate with your neighbors. You could talk from who knows how far away, like hey, how you doing? Thanks for watching, makers. And as always, keep calm and make on.